Fine. All ready? No, Drew, what happened? Drew, what happened? Okay, fine. So first question is in front of you.
So
Measuring volume. Hang
can you show it in the PowerPoint?
on.
Yes, so can you show it in?
Okay, this is the question. Measuring volume of liquids is fundamental aspect of experimental chemistry. The diagram shows three different pieces of apparatus used for this task. Which row is correct? Okay, Vibha, we can't increase the font because the question is that much big. So I can't increase font more than this.
Sir, I
So
just can't
it's
say in time because of that.
Yes, sir. No,
it
what?
says time's up. There was so less time for me.
Ah, yes, that's why I told you see time. It's
That's
very easy.
easy. So, but you didn't show. Yes, sir. So,
So, sir,
but
by the time you
we
showed here, we
couldn't
had
do
to read
that.
the question by that time. The time got
No,
over.
the
There were
time
10 more
was
seconds extra.
okay. Time was 30 seconds. Time was 30 seconds I
So,
put
can
for
we
this question.
redo this one, please?
No, redo. Why you want to redo? No.
There was
30
no
seconds
time.
was allotted because it is very easy question. They ask which is the burette, which is pipette, which is measuring cylinder. If you know, you could have answered. But if you don't know, there is no other option. You have
So I
to.
knew the answer, but the
No,
time was too
we have to
much.
read the question. So we have to read the question to know the answers.
Sir, I knew the answer, but same.
So next time, could you
Okay.
please make the
I
font
know.
big so it hurts
Yes,
our eyes,
okay.
sir?
Okay, fine, fine. See, listen, only this
Yes,
question
first
has
of all,
30
it's so big that we
seconds.
have to switch tabs and complete that it's small, and then you have to open the slide. That's a lot of time, sir.
Okay, fine. No problem. Listen, answer of this question is A. Okay, why A? This is the burette. Burette is used to measure the volume added in the solution. Whenever we add something in a big container, in the container, if you put the burette, over burette, what happens? Burette can you can control the flow of liquid. Okay, in acid-base reaction, generally we use burette. So this is known as burette. This is known as measuring cylinder, and this is known as pipette. In this pipette, we need to suck the solution from pipette because exact volume we needed for a small volume, let's say 25 ml and all, we can exactly measure from the pipette. So answer is A. Any doubt, students? No doubt? Okay. Now next question. This is the only question which has 30 seconds. Rest all you can do it fast. Okay, there is one more question which has put 40 seconds time limit. So please read the question carefully and you have time. Please use, see the time first. Okay, and questions are big because you can see that if I want to show the diagram, questions could be like this only. Now I will show you screen again. The question is in. Okay, first we'll see the. Okay, this is the reading. I will show you questions just after this. Okay, if you have again, if you want to see question, this is the next question. It is in front of you. Okay, now if you want to see screen, this is the screen. Please let me know once time got over. Please let me know once time get over. Time over. Very good. So answer for this question. Okay, what is that? If you see properly, this is increasing here. So this is 17.5, and you always write the reading where you have a lower meniscus. There is one thing called as lower meniscus. Okay, whenever in the laboratory when you go, so you always write the lower meniscus. So you take reading from this point, and this point is reading is nothing but 17.8. Reading is 17.8. Okay. Now here if you see the reading, 30, 32, 34. Reading is 34. 17.8 and 34. C is correct. Answer is C. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. We'll see the leaderboard. And it's very disappointing. 20 students only have answered this question right. Why, students? It was not that tough question. Okay, it was easy question. But yes, it was little.
So the font was so small and then.
Okay, now don't say font was small.
So the font was small and then my screen was lagging.
Sir, the
screen was lagging, so I couldn't see the
enlarged
question. So that's
why.
You just come in. Share screen and you can see.
Aditya, if you zoom in, you lose resolution. Try it yourself.
Okay, students, this is only which can I do. I can once start and I will show you the PPT. In next moment only.
Sir, it's completely fine, sir.
Okay, sir, fine. Next question, fine. We are going to.
Sir, it's fine, sir. No problem.
I'll show you question immediately after showing the. I'll show you the. PPT immediately after showing the question. So Pratham is leading again. Fine, good Pratham, keep it up. Next question is in front of you. If I am showing the screen, if you want to see, question number 3 is this. Please see question number 3. Solid tea melts at exactly 60 degrees Celsius and boils at exactly 310 degrees Celsius. Solid tube dissolves in ethanol and shows a green color and a yellow color when analyzed using paper chromatography. Which row is correct? Please don't make mistakes. Why I have given these type of questions? Because I know that many of you just overlook the question. Okay, please let me know once time get over. Okay, don't. Please. Read question carefully. I think last time, if all of you, those who have marked A, because you have not read the values properly, that's why you marked A in last question. So please read the question carefully. Okay, time's up. Okay, fine. P melts at exactly 60. Now this question uses two concepts. P melts at exactly 60 and boils at exactly 310. Pure substance, you all know that pure substance has fixed melting point and boiling point. Fixed melting point and boiling point. So this is a pure substance. So contains only one substance. So P contains only one substance. So only possible answer seems is D. Only possible answer is D. Okay, let's check. Solid tube dissolved in ethanol and shows green color and yellow color. If two spots are observed means definitely Q is a mixture of two substances. This means Q is having more than one substance. Answer is D. Hope you understood this. Any doubt? No? Sure? Would we go to next one? Okay, 29 have answered it right. Good students, keep it up. Next question is in front of you. First, I'll show you the leaderboard.
Sir, to move faster, you can do Alt Tab, sir.
Okay, don't worry. I'll show you it fast only. It will take hardly 2 seconds. Okay, now, are you all ready for next question? I'm showing you the next question. So next question is in front of you. Pure H2O boils at 100 degrees Celsius and freezes it at 0 degrees Celsius. What is the melting point and boiling point of water after addition of potassium chloride? Please read question carefully and then answer. Hmm. Why, Suchir? Why you misclicked? I don't know. Last time also you said misclick. I think. Okay. Is it clear? Tell me. Okay, fine. I think it time's up. Yes?
No, sir.
Oh, still not. Please let me know. Okay, fine. So, which has pure boiling boils
not
at
yet.
Oh, sorry. Someone has written time's up. Pranav, why?
So now time's up.
So now.
Okay, fine. Question number, it's 100 degrees Celsius and 0 degrees Celsius. Now, pure water boils, you know that when you add impurity, in any liquid, okay, its melting point decreases and boiling point increases. So, boiling point will go to 103 degrees Celsius and melting point decreases to minus 3 degrees Celsius. Answer for this question is A. Am I clear to all of you? Okay, fine. So, yes.
Sir,
yes.
So basically the range of the temperature increases with impurity, right?
Range of temperature increases, yes, exactly. But it is in the range, if it is an impurity, is in the range, but definitely boiling point will increase slightly. Understood? That whenever there are impure substances, you can say that it is not a fixed temperature, but definitely the temperature of boiling point will increase. Similarly, I explained you in the class, and I think I explained some in some pentamer also. Whenever it is like, just a minute. Yes, whenever you add salt in water, its boiling point increases. Whenever you add salt in water, its melting point decreases. That's why you can preserve fish in a, you know, the what you generally we use to preserve fish, or the this person who wants to preserve fish, what they do, they put the salt in water and then they freeze it, so the melting point of ice get reduced, so you can preserve fish or these food items for longer time. And similarly, if you want to increase temperature of the substance, you add some boiling point, you add some salt. Understood? Any doubt in this? It is very basic concept, but I can see only 20 students have answered it right. Okay, fine. Next question. All ready? Okay, fine. So I'm moving to the next question. Oh, fine. Srijan is leading. Very good, Srijan. Moving to the next one. This is the question. Oh, sorry. I think you can see the question in tab. Students carry out an investigation of different plant extract using paper chromatography. The experiment setup he uses is shown below. Paper pencil line solvent. Where should he place the sample of plant extract? Like, where should he put plant extract to observe the chromatogram or to get the chromatogram? Okay, students, please revise your notes in time, do questions, solve all the, there are so many, I told you in last class also, 9, INR 9 students, that attempt questions, it is given in the what you say.
So, time
up. Okay, fine. Question is very easy. Whenever you want to do the chromatography, you put your sample on this pencil line. What happens? Your solvent goes up. when the solvent goes up, it will take your dot also in the upward direction. So whatever things which are more soluble in your, whatever things which are more soluble in your solvent, things or the component which are more soluble in solvent, the things which are more soluble will report higher in the chromatogram, will report higher in chromatogram. What does this mean? Like if I have mixture of A and B on this dot, and if A is more soluble, so could you tell me if after I get this chromatogram, and the two dots are this and the second dot is somewhere this and this is your pencil line. Can you please tell me which dot is A, the top one or the bottom one?
The red one is A
and this one is B, because it can't travel more. So this is the chromatography. One question I will ask you, there will be one question. So to tell you that, do you know retention factor? Those who don't know, for them I am telling you retention factor. There is something called as retention factor. What is the retention factor formula? I am telling you now, it will be used in one of the... I did not tell you retention factor in class, that's why I am telling you now. In next class I will take that. Okay, I will tell you the retention factor is in next class. Okay, so retention factor is nothing but if you have things going up, retention factor, you know, this is a chromatogram, and in your chromatogram, this is the level of your solvent. This is nothing but your chromatogram. This is chromatogram. After chromatography, you get this, and this is your level of solvent. Your solvent will reach at this point. So what is the retention factor? Distance moved by component A in like A or B, whatever you want to calculate. Let's say you want to calculate retention factor of A, so you will write distance moved by component A from baseline divided by distance moved by solvent front, you can say, from baseline. Please remember this formula. If you want to know what is this formula, if let's say this distance is x, where your solvent has moved and your A has moved distance y, if this is the distance moved by the A and this is distance y and this is nothing but baseline, so formula is retention factor of A is nothing but, what is the formula, tell me, what is the value of retention factor of A? Distance moved by component in from the baseline, how much distance it moved? Y by x or x by y? Okay, students, right?
The y by x.
Okay, Tanvi, I know that you didn't learn. That's why I'm explaining it now. Try to learn now. Retention factor is y by x or x by y? It is. Okay, all of you, INR 9 students, right? What is the distance moved? X by y or y by x? Okay, distance moved by component A is nothing but x, and distance moved by component is nothing but y, because I am talking about A. A has moved to this point. Till this point A has moved. That's why it is y by x, not x by y. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, no problem, Monisha. But did you understand? Answer is y by x. This formula will be used in one of the question. Be ready. Okay. Now, next question is, okay, is it clear to all of you? Could I move to next question? Okay, answer for this question is A. On the pencil line. You put that dot in the pencil line. Answer is A. And this is the retention factor which you are going to use in question number 7. Okay? So be ready for that. Now, next question is in front of you. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, students. Moving to the next question. This is the next question. Paper chromatography are used to determine if a banned preservative X is present in 4 samples obtained from 4 different packaged food labeled ABCD. Okay, Menti code I return you. Okay, okay, student, once time get over, please let me know. So,
sir, time's up.
Okay, 112001877. Okay, so now see, answer of this is what? If you see paper chromatography, ABCD, 4 things are 4 samples you have. And this is the chromatogram, this is the movement of your X, actual X, which is banned substance. Actually, you know, chromatography is used in the food industries. It is used in the food industry and in drugs. And for drugs also we use. So what happens? In pharmaceutical it is used a lot. So if this is a banned substance, definitely your banned substance has how many components? Can you tell me? Banned substance has how many components? One or two? It has two components. It definitely have two components because a banned substance is giving you two dots in a chromatogram. So if I say the banned substance is having a mixture of A and B, definitely it is having a A and B in it. Okay, so it is having A and B. Now see, A and B are already used. So I will write it like Y, okay, I'll write like M and N. The two banned, in the banned substance you have two components M and N. Okay, if you see the A is not having, it is having M but it is not having N. Means it is not your banned substance. It is not X. X is not there. If you see the B, it is having N also. See the same level. It is having M also. See, it is also on the same level. So, yes, B is the answer. C is having M. C is having M but not N. C is not having N because it is slightly in the upper side than actual N is. So it is not the answer. D is definitely not the answer because it is having only N, not M. So answer for this question is B. Let us see how many of you have done this question right. Did you understand first? Tell me. Did you understand this?
Yes, sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. I'll show you the answer. Okay, I'll show you the result. Fine, very, it's not that bad. 36 have answered it right. Okay, Anuhya Novak has COVID. Okay, fine. So next question I am going to show you now. Be ready for that. Okay, this is the next question. 4 different labeled PQRS are produced in a chromatogram as shown below. This is the solvent front. This is the baseline. Which dye has RF value 0.7? I already told you I will ask in question number 7 about RF value. Which RF value, what solvent front I told you last class, solvent front I told you, I last question, question number 5, that time I told you students, if you have any doubt, please ask.
So, but you haven't given the values.
Huh, it's not required. I will tell you when I will solve this question. Just think, students, it's very easy question. Have you done? Okay, please let me know once time get over.
Sir, time's up.
Okay, fine. Student, answer for this is, Monisha, you asked her what is solvent front. I told you, you have a baseline, your solvent is moving up. The height where your solvent, the maximum height of your solvent is the solvent front from the baseline. Your solvent moves till the highest point of the chromatogram, that is nothing but solvent front. But your mixture which you are taking may not move till the solvent front. It will go along with the solvent but not till the highest point. Now they have given RF as 0.7. RF is nothing but distance traveled by your let's say what they have given, label PQRS chromatogram. Okay, distance traveled by component divided by distance of solvent front. Distance of solvent front from baseline. In last question also I have written the same formula. Solvent front from baseline. Okay, so if you see 0.7 is the answer. So which distance it seems like a 0.7? If this is the distance 1, where is the 0.7? I think it should be around this. This distance should be 0.7. So this one is the 0.7. So here you have to just, there is no point value given, but you have to imagine where you will get the 0.7 value. So 0.7 correspond to this S. So answer is A. Okay, again I am repeating. This is the 0.7 if it is 1 centimeter. Because if I assume it as 1 centimeter, if I assume it as 1 centimeter, RF is 0.7 means distance of component moved is 0.7 from the baseline. This is the baseline. From the baseline your distance moves to be 0.7. Is it clear to all of you? Here you need to think which is the 0.7. Okay, what is the value correspond to this point? Any idea? Any guess? What is the point? What is the RF value for this point? RF value for this point?
So maybe 0.2.
Maybe 0.2. Very good. So you need to guess. Yes, it is 0.2. Maybe 0.2, 0.2, 0.5, 0.25, like that. Understood? Yes, P and Q are not the answer. Yes, P and Q are.
Definitely know that from baseline to solvent front, it will always be 1 centimeter.
No, it's not 1 centimeter. I have assumed, my dear. Oh. I'm just saying that if I consider this as a X and if I consider this as a Y, according to my formula, it is X by Y. I can definitely say that Y is 70%, X is 70% of Y. I can surely tell that. Okay, if you don't want 1 centimeter, assume it as 100 centimeter. If Y is 100 centimeter and RF is 0.7, so definitely RF is 0.7 means your X must be 70 centimeter. Am I clear to you?
Yes, I got it.
It is not that same 1 centimeter, just assume it. Okay, Monisha, it is around 8.8. You know this is around 0.8. This is around 0.9. Like that. Yes, I understand these are very close, sure. close
sir?
Values. Yes.
You said that it's the distance of solvent front. That means the top of the solvent, right?
Yes, top of the solvent.
Yeah.
You know what happens? I told you solvent
so
goes.
So the rest
up
of it is clearly not 0.7 because it's much more the top of the solvent.
Sorry, repeat.
the top of the solvent of P and Q is much higher, even though the bottom of it is at the same level as S, but the top is much higher, so it's not P and Q, right?
1 minute. Can you repeat your? Can you repeat what you want to say? This is the solvent front. Now tell me what. Please repeat. In P, your dot is moving till point.
Yeah, I got
P.
It.
Understood.
No, I meant to say that like the distance that the dot travels is it at the top of the ellipse or is it in the middle of the ellipse?
Okay, fine. It should be middle of the ellipse.
Okay.
Okay. Otherwise, this also. It's not justified for this answer also. Understood?
Yeah. Okay.
It is the middle of ellipse. Okay. Monisha, did you understand? Actually, C and A are very close to each other. It's like you can get confused with the C and A, but best answer would be A.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, I get your points. I just want to say that this is slightly unfair because it's slightly hard to guess whatever.
Yes,
which
one. I know. I understand that. I understand that. If you see this value and if you see this value, okay, so I can say that this distance is, if I understand your point, this is not, it is slightly greater than 70% of this. If this is the 100 thing, if this is the 100 thing, it is slightly greater than 70. You can say 75 or 80. I understand your point, but answer is this only. Understood? If you measure with the scale also, but we don't need to measure. You need to go get the best answer. Okay. I want to tell one more thing. Yes. So this is the only way you can do this question. Understood, Monisha? And it's
yes,
most,
sir.
It's okay. Fine. But you should understand the concept. It's fine if you got it wrong, because actually those who have marked it, see, they are not absolutely wrong, but fine. There is some, because you don't have the measurement to do there, it's fine. Don't worry. Okay, moving to the next question. Okay, fine. Next question is in front of you. A student has been given a sample of amino acid to analyze by chromatography. As part of the investigation, the student will have to use the locating agent to make the colorless amino acid spots visible. The RF value is then calculated to identify the amino acid. Which row describes the correct step? Locating agent. I said something about locating agent in class. We use locating agents. Now, what is the purpose of that? And which step? Okay, this is the one technique which is not given in detail in NCRT, because most of you are having NCRT. It is not given in detail. Even RNR9 students have not this in detail. That's why I took chromatography. Everything distillation, fractionated distillation, you have in detail. But chromatography, they don't talk about much about chromatography, but it is very important. Okay, fine. It times up?
Not yet.
Okay, RNR is having different syllabus. What happened, Tanya? Times up, Tanya, what happened? Which concept is not clear? Tell me. Tanya? Can you please speak up? What happened? Tanya, please unmute your mic. Okay, you are getting questions wrong. That's what I'm saying. Please, if you remember, I explained so many things in last class. And that's why I'm taking this is the topic which you have discussed in class, chromatography. If you remember, I told you about the locating agent. Whenever the substance which is not colored, we use the locating agent to get, because there are sometimes if you want to separate A and B, when sometimes you want to separate A and B and you put it in the chromatography or in the, if you run chromatography for that, A and B get separated. A is having some point, B is having some point. But what happens sometimes, they don't show different colors. So what we do, we put some locating agent, we spray some locating agents there. So spray on the surface of the solvent. Okay, oh sorry, spray on the chromatogram, not on the solvent. Spray on the chromatogram. Not before experiment, after experiment you do. If you put before experiment, what problem may cause? Or what problem might happen if you put before chromatography? What problem could happen? Please tell me. It might shift, yes, because you need to separate A and B. If you put locating agent also, that will show its other point, third point. Okay, we don't want to increase more things in the mixture. We want only A and B to get separated. So spray the chromatogram, spray on the chromatogram. Chromatogram is called when you are done with the chromatography. Then the thing which you got is called as chromatogram. Then compare the RF value to the known amino acid. What happens once you got this dot? Let's say after putting the spray, you are getting this dot as red dot. You are getting this red dot once you put the spray. Now you will check with the data which you have, which are available with you. When you calculate RF value for this dot, let's say RF value comes out to be 0.354. So you will compare like which compound is having the RF value 0.354. Example, if I have A and B, I get a boiling point of A is equals to 100 degree Celsius. What can I say about A? Can I say like it is more likely to be water? Can I say it is more likely to be water because boiling point is 100 degree Celsius? Yes or no? Similarly, whenever RF value you are getting, let's say 0.354, you will compare with the known data. If something has RF 0.35, we will say your mixture is most likely to have that compound. So compare the RF value to that known amino acids. Okay? This is probably the last question for the chromatography. Okay, any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Answer is B. Okay, students, next question is in front of you. Please be careful. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, so here you have the result. 17 were right. Okay, be ready for next question. So in many cases you have to think everything. I there are chances that I can't tell everything in class, but you need to think, you need to apply the concept. It's common sense that if you add locating agent before the chromatography, it may create problem in chromatography. What happened, Raghav, any doubt?
So every chemistry period, I just have a feeling that Jagrav comes first every time, and in maths class he used like some kind of shady ways to get there.
Okay, now see, we are going to the next question. Are you all ready? Okay, Jagrav is leading. I think he's coming. He's again. Okay, we'll see what will happen. I don't know. Okay, next question is in front of you. It's very easy question, but it is having very less time. Now this is not at all related to chromatography, but just your imagination. You need to imagine. Now here you need to use your imagination, students. How you can get 4 if you have 2? If you have 2, how you can get 4? Okay. Hands up.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very easy question. you have this shape and you want to make it as a filter, you know, this is how you make the filter, how you do the filtration in lab. You have this thing. This is a filter paper. You turn it like this, and in next step, you fold it in this way and you put it like this. You make it like this, and in next step, you put finger inside this area where you can see there is a gap. You will get filter paper like this. So answer for this question is A. So this is totally imagination based question, no chemistry at all. Let us see how many of you have done this question right. Only 22. Yes, what happened? Okay, next question.
Sir, D is the same as A. D is same
what
as
happened? A. No, C is D, not D. Same as A. D is also okay, I'll show you. Wait. Yes. See, D is
sir,
not
D
showing.
Is a piece of paper. Sir, D
yes.
is just a single piece of
yes.
paper.
Yes, it is single piece of paper. That's what I told you. Please see the option carefully. Very good. Next question. A yellow solute W is soluble in water. Which method of separation can be used to obtain W from aqueous solution? Okay, Monisha asked to re-explain. Okay, Monisha, I will explain it after this question. Okay, Monisha, after this. Okay, time over. So answer for this question is solution W, yellow solid, W is soluble. Now soluble, there are two options where you can get confused. That's why I add question. Distillation and crystallization. But you need to get the solid only. You are not interested in collecting the liquid. So answer will be crystallization, not distillation. So answer is D. Monisha. I'll show you the question number. Okay, just give me 1 second, student. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. I'll show you one video if I could show you. Just 1 minute.
Please switch your stop.
Okay, students, 1 minute, 1 minute. I'll share my screen. Okay, please, 1 minute. Okay, just a minute. If I can see some video, I will tell you. It's very easy. Just a minute. Okay, yes. So I'll show you one video in that you can understand it. It's very easy to understand. Mm-hmm. Okay, please mute your mic, students. Okay, hope you can see my screen now. And there is a filter paper you can see. Just a minute. Okay, this is the filter paper you have. Okay, you need to think like how. This is the circular filter paper. Okay, please try to understand what you have done, what she has done. Please see. Monisha, did you understand this? Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is how you make the filter paper. Okay, if you want to see the question, it was the question. This A is the answer. You have folded it one more time, that's it. Okay, fine. Next question is... okay, students. Next question is in front of you. Okay, here also you people have done very bad in this question also. Okay, we'll see the leaderboard first. Okay, fine. Now Jagrav is again leading. Okay, fine. So we are moving to next question. Good, Jagrav. Next question is in front of you. The diagram below illustrates the experimental setup to carry out distillation. Which are the correct labels for point A and B on the condenser? I don't think you have much time. You have just 60 seconds for this question. Please let me know once time get over.
Sir, I lost connection. Can you repeat the code?
Okay, now code. I don't. 1 minute. I'll show you code. 1 minute. 6500.
Wrong this Wi-Fi.
Excuse me, sir. You are muted.
So you got muted.
So screen froze. That means.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. I just wanted to see the result first. See, friend. 33 students. Okay, it is very good question and very easy also. See, this is the question. You know, you add water from this end and you take. Answer is adding water at point A, water in at A, and water out at B. Answer is B. Okay, why it is like that? Because you know that what happens? The temperature at this point is very high. Sir. Here temperature is very high and here yes. What happened? Tell me. Okay, temperature is very high, temperature is very low. So when you add water, your water goes up. It is with the water has some pressure. So it goes up and it takes most of the heat or it takes heat from the, okay, not from this path. Sorry, by mistake I've drawn. It goes on this path. It goes in this path and will be taken out from B, point B. Is it clear? Because you need to extract maximum heat. If you do like other way around, if you put water inside B through B, and if you take it out from A, then water will not going to get more heat from the your distillation chamber or this distillate condenser. It will not condense your solution much. That's why we do this process. Hope you got the point. Any doubt? Any doubt?
Sir,
no doubt. Yes.
Can't be A or D, because in one there'll be no water, in the other there'll be too much water, that the thing will burst. Sir, some random.
Okay, 1 minute. What? Okay. Can you repeat?
So some random
okay, you can't share screen as well. Okay, please unshare 1 minute. Who is this?
Satvik, stop sharing.
Click on sirs and same, change to presenter.
Yes, change to presenter.
Okay. Okay, 1 minute. Who is this? 1 minute. Okay, students, don't worry. I'm showing you the screen in 1 minute. Okay, can you hear me? Can you hear me now? We are moving to the next question.
Yes, sir.
We are moving to the next. Okay, someone has some doubt in that previous question. Please ask if you have any doubt. Yes, any doubt? Someone asked something like, sir, if that will burst or something like that. No? No doubts? Fine. We are moving to the next question.
That it can be neither A or D, because in one there will be no water and in the other there will be too much water that it will burst.
No. Why it will burst? Why it will burst? Like, yes, it is not... Yeah, it is going in the outer...
No, sir, like in B, the in A.
Okay, your
the
voice is breaking.
Sir, like in A.
Your voice is breaking, my dear. I can't hear you.
Sir, can you hear me now?
Yes, tell me.
Yes, sir. I was just saying that in A, the thing might break because there's so much of water, there's no place for water to exit.
Why? Okay, it is like this. Try to understand. Okay, try to understand. It won't break. Why it won't break? Because it is in the outer side. It is going in the outer side. Okay, this is the condenser. Try to understand. This is the condenser, which is going like this. And your water is going inside like this. Your water goes in this path. And since there is nothing in this, this is completely vacant. So it goes like this and it come out like this. Understood? It won't burst at all.
No, sir, but what if both sides are water in? Then it will burst.
Then it will burst.
So that's what I was saying.
Okay. Any doubt? Answer is B. Okay, next. So someone has marked A also. Okay. Now this is the result. Fine, we are moving to the next question. The diagram below illustrates. Okay, fine, next question, sorry. Okay, you know, don't worry. I want to see how many of you are in the second and third position. I want to see all of you. First three position I want to check. So let us see what will happen. And you also check like whether you have improved or not. Okay, I have given questions which are a little tougher also, I know. Now here you need to think a lot. Lot means okay, it's a very tricky question. You might not think in that direction, but let us see what will happen. Yes, please let me know once time get over. Okay. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Should I explain this question? Okay, students, please don't chat. Okay, should I explain?
Sir, time's not up.
Okay. Okay, fine. Now it time's up. I'll explain you this question. Wait. Yes. So, answer for this question is A. Very good question. Why it is A? Because you are having HCl here and you are having ammonia here. Now I want to ask from you people, which is heavy? HCl is heavy or ammonia is heavy? Think and tell me, which is heavier? If you can answer this question right, means you will definitely get answer in next step. Which is heavier, ammonia or HCl? Okay, I'm getting mixed answer. Ammonia or HCl? If you see the periodic table, HCl is heavy. Okay, we have done some questions related to that. this is heavy.
So it's HCl.
Yes, and it is lighter. So, or it is lighter. Now see, if something is heavy, now it is nothing but diffusion is taking place. Diffusion. Now tell me which will diffuse more? Both are diffusing. Both are diffusing. Which will diffuse more? Heavier one or lighter one? Heavier one will diffuse less. Lighter one will diffuse more. I told you in the last class also, the thinner person can run fast than the fat person. So HCl won't diffuse much, but NH3 will diffuse a lot. So that NH3 will travel more distance than HCl. So precipitate, that is ammonium chloride, will form somewhere around A. So answer is A. Students, you are chatting continuously. Did you understand this question or not? Answer is A. Salt will form near to A. Is it clear? Yes, students, do you have any doubt? Okay, fine. Next question. Okay, next question is, you will not having much time for this. Please attempt it fast. Okay, question is this: evaporation, sponge.
Sir, you have not clicked it on Menti.
Okay, fine, no problem. It is. I have already clicked. Let's see. You have 30 more seconds. Okay, fine. It is very easy question. 15 more seconds. Okay, fine. Students, I'll explain this question now. So, okay, time's up. If you want to see the result, answer is B. Answer is B. How? Evaporation is used, liquid into vapor, not above room temperature. A is as sponge is solid. P, virus is diffusion. Fusion is melting. Boiling is vapor above room temperature. R, SP, okay, sorry, SPQTR. Answer is 2. Any doubt, students? Do you have any doubt? No? Next question is in front of you, students. Be ready for that. Okay, if you want to see the leaderboard, you can see it. Very good, Srijan, Jagra, Vihan, Gandhar, very good. Okay, next question. Iodine, temperature given, iodine, sulfur, sea water, pure water, ice and common salt. Okay, Vibha, bye. Okay, students. Please answer it fast. 20 have only answered so far. Don't make mistake this time. Okay, students, why you are worrying about Jagrav, I don't know. If let's say, first of all, if he is playing very good. Second thing, let's say if he is voting, why you are worried? You should not be worried about someone other, because if someone is cheating, it is because so he is creating problem for him, or if someone is creating, or he or she is creating problem for him or her. So why you people are worried? Time's up. Okay, fine. Answer for this is iodine. Iodine is nothing but sublimation. R, iron plus sulfur, mixture of two elements. S, sea water. I told you it has salt. Salt plus water, higher boiling point. Higher boiling point. So answer is C. Pure water, 100 degree Celsius. Q, ice plus common salt. Only option left is P, temperature below 0 degree Celsius. That is nothing but melting point they want to say. RSTPQP. RST. Okay, RSTQP. Sorry, QP. Answer is A. Hope you understood this. Any doubt? Any doubt? No? Last question. Okay. Last question. It is very easy question. Okay, very good, Jagrav, Srijan, Bihan, Gandhar. Very good. Last question is in front of you. Mixture of ZnCl2 and PbCl2 can be separated by. Okay, this is the last question anyways. Very easy question, but you need to think little bit in this. You can go with the elimination option also, if you are getting confused. Okay, fine, students. It is last 15 seconds. Okay, option is there. Okay, fine. Option E is correct. Okay, students, answer for this question is, time's up. Answer of this question is crystallization. B, distillation is not carried out for the solid and liquid. Sublimation is always applicable for sublimable substance. Adding acetic acid won't work. Okay? Because both are soluble in acetic acid. So it won't give you any answer. It won't give you any of the sort. So answer is crystallization. What you do once you heat it, PbCl2 get dissolved in water. Because it is soluble in water, or it's soluble in hot water. Once it gets dissolved, you can remove that in Cl2, then you can use crystallization technique. So crystallization is the answer. Let us see how many of you got this. 25. Those who have marked 7B option, they might have got confused. So today's result is this. Okay, students, we'll see who won. Okay, very good. Srijan, Bihan, Jagrav, Siddhant, Gandhar. Very good. Srijan, Siddhant, Gandhar, Bihan and Jagrav. Very good. Okay, keeping up, students. Very good, Jagrav. Congratulations. Thank you. Students, if anyone has any doubt, please ask. No doubts? Sure. Okay, students. Thank you. Okay, don't worry. If you think like Jagrav, he comes first every time. Don't worry, you see second, third, fourth positions are also there. Don't worry. Okay. Bye, students. Okay, no problem.
Thank you, sir. Amazing bye. Quiz. Thank you, sir. Amazing quiz.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, Rohan.
Thank you. So this was Dhruv.
Okay, Dhruv, bye. Thank you.